least you bastards are good for something.
Audio recording of Kessler follows.
Final preparations nearly complete. The device will be delivered to the corner of 19th and Sloat at 1900 hours, with detonation following 2 minutes later. Post-blast, the device will be retrieved and placed into stasis while I await the results. In case the event doesn't bring about the desired results, a second event will be scheduled.
I was a little worried you weren't gonna show.
So what's going on?
The ray sphere is up at the top of this tower. Once we have it, we're getting the hell out of here. You in?
It's up there. Hell yeah, I'm in.
Come on, we need to climb up this damn thing. Head over to the elevator and I'll figure out a way to bring you up. John. He told me it's up here.
John? You mean Moya's husband?
He says he's not her husband. Never heard of her.
What the hell does that mean?
It means that one of them is lying. Just don't know which one.
Fool, I told you not to trust the feds. You ain't still thinking about turning over the ray sphere to him, are you?
John says he wants me to help him destroy it. Seems like a good idea to me.
Destroy it? Yeah, right. I bet my bottom dollar he just wants to fire that baby up. Or sell it off to someone for some serious cashola. Come on, man, don't just stand around. Let's go! You need to get going.
wish this had never happened to me. I'm nothing but a damned errand boy, same as before. Going where people tell me, when they tell me, I'm starting to think that's never gonna change.
No way, man. Once we get that race fair, nobody will say as much as boo to either one of us. You can mark my words on that one.
I hope you're right, Zeke. I really do.
There, Cole. We're running out of time. What the hell's going on? There's no one even up here.
I know you, both of you. Locked me up like an animal. Tied me to that bed. Tried to electrocute me. I showed you, though. You and those pigs.
Zeke, stay back there. When I give the word, you go for the race sphere. I'll keep all of it off you. Let's do it.
I know why you're here, what you want. Nobody's taking a damn thing from me!
I know the way out of this hellhole runs through you, Alden. And by God, you're not stopping. Zeke, stay back there. When I give the word, you go for the race sphere. I'll keep Alden off you.
Let's do this.
I know why you're here, what you want. Nobody's taking a damn thing from me!
My only way out of this hellhole runs through you, Alden. And by God, you're not stopping me.
You're a fool, boy. Only seeing what others show you. But you'll learn soon enough.
Zeke, do it.
Go! My childhood! My home! You dare come here!
Poor, poor Alden. All that potential squandered. Your father would have been so disappointed.
You dare mention my father! I'll kill you! All of you! Tear you from limb to limb!
Zeke, get out of here! Run!
Zeke yanked the ray sphere out of its cradle and was caught between Alden and Kessler. It was definitely time to escape, but he just stood there, petrified. You see, through the fear, he realized that the key to his dreams, the tool to make him superpowered, was right between his hands. Asshole makes the choice to kill thousands, stealing their lives so that he'll be transformed, and then... nothing. Everyone's fine. No change at all. Kessler's first to grasp the situation. Claims to know what's wrong. If Zeke brings him the ray sphere, Kessler will be able to give Zeke the powers he craves. My best friend looks me in the eye and then makes his second mistake. Alden goes ballistic at the loss of the sphere. The tower shakes and it starts to rip apart. But I was just dumbfounded. Barely felt the impact.
I told you to pick someone you could trust. 93 seconds.
Zeke's my best friend, like a brother to me. He's about the only person I do trust. Or did, anyway.
Well, you blew it. And now Alden's on a killing spree and Kessler has the ray sphere. We need to resolve both situations. 63 seconds.
I'm starting to think none of this is my problem. Maybe I should just let those two slug it out and then swoop in and nab the sphere when the dust settles.
What if one of them activates it and kills another 10,000 people in the process? And who the hell knows what that Moya person wants with it? No. This is the only way. 38 seconds.
You'd better be serious about destroying it. I'm in no mood.
You have my word. Alden's heading into the historic district. Catch up to him, take him out, and then look for Kessler. I'll be in touch. Tearing across that bridge, heading for the historic district. Stop him before he reaches the other side.
I'm on it.
Cole, what the hell is going on? There's something wrong with your phone. Every time I try and call you, I get disconnected.
I don't have time to run tech support for you, Moya. Figure it out yourself. Later.
Thank you.
You're back there, Electric Man! Stop me! No one will!
Alden, this ends now. Holy shit.
Ignorant pissant! This is what my father wanted. Me! Governing all that I could see. My destiny will be fulfilled. You're like Kessler, craving what doesn't belong to you. None of you understand, see the truth, but I do. I see it all. You think you can hurt me? Nothing can compare with what I've endured, what I survived. You and Kessler are one and the same.
You've got some serious issues, you know that?
We'll be right back.
and a thief of a friend. All of you.
Alden no longer seemed like a threat to anyone. Just some old guy howling about how Kessler had stolen his first son's birthright. Then he changed his tone. Claimed he wanted to work with me to get revenge, to join forces and kill Kessler. The guy must have felt my hesitation, because in that moment of indecision, he jumped. No normal man could have survived that fall, but Alden's a conduit. Same rules don't apply. Either way, this thing's coming to a head. My enemies are all gathered here in the historic district. Kessler's preparing them for the final battle. Yeah, this is the finish line. Just wish I wasn't crossing it alone.